head down the back straightaway. We'll look for a green this time by as the pace car will duck for cover. Pull down onto that infield pit road. And we will wind them up and let them loose. Super late models off of turn number four. Here they come down to the start-finish line. Green flag is out.
Jump enjoyed by Daryl Stanfold. But right now he is getting some turbulence from the Mad Dog, George Bissett. Bissett having the adrenaline. He pulls even and he will get the nostrils of that car into the lead.
Into turn three he goes. The Mad Dog on the outside takes over the top spot from Stanfold as Bissett leads them across the line. Right behind him, following closely, the 08 of Mike O'Sullivan. He works his way up and around the 48 of Larry Gelinas, who is headed to the front, as is Derek Ranstrom in that 35 car.
Ranstrom is able to hurricane his way underneath the 11 of Stanfold. So he has invaded fourth place. We're going to have a battle for the lead. Bissett is owning the top spot, but all over him, like stitches on a baseball, the 08 of O'Sullivan, and O'Sullivan is able to nitro his way into the lead.
Mike does indeed do that. He takes it deep into turn number three, inches ahead of the Mad Dog, and Gelinas tries to follow him through the same opener. The Mad Dog tries to hold off that hard-charging Larry Gelinas in car number 48. They run side by side. Gelinas on the inside. Bissett up high. Ramstrom looking over every bit of that racing action as these drivers run side by side off of turn number four. Ramstrom almost makes it three wide at the line. A touch back in behind the 48 car.
And Bissett had some giddy up as he protects his second place turf a little deeper in the field. We have Jim Banfield trying to move up, but Ricky Fuller is a notch ahead of him. Here comes Gelinas trying to make a bold move underneath Bissett. Bissett has a spot all over the graphic paper is a 48 of Gelinas, and Bissett responded to that challenge.
While all this is going on, car number 08 with Mike O'Sullivan at the controls has opened up about a 6 or 8 car length advantage over the Mad Dog and the rest of the field. And O'Sullivan has a pretty easy run of it here tonight as he watches everybody really slug it out for that
second. O'Sullivan has a lead, but Derek Ranstrom is all over him like a ring around a bathtub, looking for room down low. Gelinas and Bissett battling for third and fourth. And look who has moved up. Mike Stefanik in car number 19. He has become a factor in that fluorescent number 19 car.
Stefanik, an incredibly versatile driver, obviously doing very well tonight in the Modified Racing Series. 7-time champion of the NASCAR Wheel and Modified Tour. If it's got wheels on it, Mike Stefanik can drive it. And you can see that right before your very eyes here tonight. Side by side, Gelinas down low, the Mad Dog up high. Your eyes dart back and forth between that battle and the battle up front as Derek Ranstrom continues to run in the tracks of Mike O'Sullivan's car number 08.
Now, the car usually gets away from Gelinas later on in the race. That is not the case tonight as he made a great move on Bissett to climb into the top three. Now, Stefanik after Gelinas in trouble. Jimmy Silva is in disarray as he climbed over. Who is that, Russ? The 50, perhaps, of Jeremy Rulli?
I believe it is.
And those two cars get together as the 36. He got his tire tracks all over the driver's window of that number 50 car. So we'll take our breath. The first yellow flag coming with 13 laps to go. What a battle between O'Sullivan and Ranstrom.
More of that. As the lights have been turned out around the speedway, it looks like we are set to go back to green. Pace car on to pit road. Here they come. O'Sullivan wastes no time jumping on the throttle. He gets the jump, leads the field back across the line. Ranstrom is second. Gelinas is third in the fourth position. Car number 19 for Mike Stefanik as he looks to the outside of Gelinas.
And a good move by Bissett as he's able to grind it out underneath Jim Banfield to move into fifth at the front of the leaderboard, O'Sullivan. Now Ranstrom has to be concerned about Gelinas. Gelinas having one of his best nights of the season. Stefanik is right there. The top four cars could fit underneath a taco shell as they go into turn number three. O'Sullivan knows he is going to get a threat from Ranstrom. So Ranstrom all over him like a dark cloud as they scamper their way into turn number one. Gelinas might be the wild card in this. He has had a quiet season so far, but he is making a lot of noise. The decibel level has increased for Gelinas in third. They come into turn number four. It is still O'Sullivan, but a traffic jam behind him. Ranstrom, maybe this is the time he is going to move like a python.
To the inside goes Derek. Can he make the move? The answer this time is no, as O'Sullivan closes the door. Mike maintains that top spot. Ranstrom holds on for second. Gelinas, not to be denied, stays there in third. Mike Stefanik rounds out the top four. Here they come back to the start-finish line. 21 up on the scoreboard now. Matt, we're inside the final 10 circuits.
And the top four continues to hang tough. Ranstrom, so far, he's tried for the lead a couple of times, but has been denied by O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan, a two-time champion, able to keep his distance between himself and Ranstrom. Stefanik, this is the best we have seen a 19-car look all season, as the top four cars could fit inside a donut hole, and maybe this is a time for Derek Ranstrom. The laps are starting to run out.
They work their way off of turn four. Here comes Derek once again. Sticks the nose down low, tries to pull up alongside O'Sullivan. They head back into turn number one. Ranstrom does not give up any real estate. O'Sullivan closes the door ever so gently and forces Ranstrom back in line. Here comes Gelinas.
As this time, Ranstrom is vulnerable. Gelinas making a bold move, trying to Tasmanian devil his way underneath Ranstrom. Ranstrom says, no way. Veto power by Derek Ranstrom to hold off Gelinas. And now Ranstrom is back to doing what he does best. Challenge Mike O'Sullivan for the lead.
Indeed he does, and there is going to be a constant challenge for the next five laps, because that's all that's remaining in this one. There's the five lap to go signal from the starter stand. Your leader, Mike O'Sullivan, car number 08. He's had a very successful run with this car, but Derek Ranstrom wants to take that away tonight. Ranstrom wants to go back and pick up where he left off. He had won the first three races this season. O'Sullivan then moved in, and Ranstrom wants to get back to the top of the heap. He's got the nose stuck inside the rear quarter panel. Can it work this time, Matt?
Let's see what happens as he tries to bury his way underneath O'Sullivan. Gelinas making a move. Gelinas striking unexpectedly underneath Ranstrom. That forces Ranstrom to go high. Now he tries to make the crossover wall against O'Sullivan. But Gelinas, he is crafty, isn't he? As he made an unexpected move and almost caught Ranstrom by surprise.
I'll tell you, these guys are putting on one heck of a race. Here comes Ranstrom once again to the inside of O'Sullivan. Mike tries to close the door, but Derek has got the nose of his car there. They lean on each other off of four at the line. It is still O'Sullivan by a half a car length.
As Ranstrom is sitting in the lap of O'Sullivan. Gelinas trying to make a move on the outside. Stefanik is there. A lap car could be a problem. Let's see. Ranstrom has to slow down. O'Sullivan is able to increase his lead as they barrel their way. One more lap to go. Here is Ranstrom. It's do or die time for the 35 car. Trying to bullet his way underneath O'Sullivan. They scorch their way down the backstretch. Ranstrom is there. O'Sullivan trying to hold on by his fingernails. Out of turn number four. Here is a move. Closing the door, O'Sullivan. Ranstrom goes around, and O'Sullivan is going to win. Gelinas in second, followed by Stefanik. Fourth will go to the 13 of Banfield. And fifth is Bissett. Then it's Maxfield, followed by the 41 of Scott Rutherford. And only completing 29 laps was Derek Ranstrom.